Austria, this is a tiny village called Kirchberg, and that's the one that Marcel mentioned, where Julian Jaynes. So this was in 1984. He presented his theory that you are all familiar with. I went there to this conference last year and gave this lecture called The Origin of Consciousness, and I had to summarize a lot of Jaynes, which I think is not necessary here with this audience. So I concentrate more on Wittgenstein. And why do I do it? Because when Jaynes gave his lecture, I was around, I was a young man, a student, and Jaynes impressed me, his theory impressed me, but what I really liked was the similarities to Wittgenstein. At least I perceived them. And I said to myself, someday I should work on it. So I'm trying to share this with you, and I will limit myself to three subjects: consciousness, pain, and language. Maybe I should start with one example of the similarity. Jaynes says that consciousness is not required for learning. And Wittgenstein says, when learning a language, for example, you need training. Training in the sense of drilling, even conditioning. Abrichtung in German. So that's my title now. So we're talking about these two guys here, mainly on Wittgenstein. I'll let you draw your own conclusions. I'm quite sure you will be able to do this. So let's start on consciousness. So Wittgenstein is rarely using the word consciousness as a technical term. So he's trying to make us understand how would we use the word consciousness. Could one imagine a stone having consciousness? Whom do I really inform if I say I have consciousness? And is being conscious or having consciousness a fact of experience? These are all quotes from the philosophical investigations. What would it mean for me to be wrong about his having a mind, having consciousness? And what would it mean for me to be wrong about myself? So these are all questions. You see, he's really fond of asking questions. And then, out of no context, there's no real argument leading to this. This is a very puzzling paragraph. In what circumstances shall I say that a tribe has a chief? And the chief must surely have consciousness. Surely we can't accept, we can't have a chief without consciousness. Now, how does that sound to you? And he goes on, but can't I imagine that the people around me are automata, lack consciousness, even though they behave in the same way as usual? Now, I suggest that you could read this as being ironically, meaning, of course we can imagine achieve without consciousness. This is exactly what what Jaynes said happened in history. So when the conquistadors came to South America, at least he says it's possible that people had no consciousness like the Europeans at the time, but soon, obviously, they developed their own consciousness.